Greetings, our Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters. This is the High Priest, L.D. Smith, the Watchman on the Wall.
And my name is V.C.E. Smith, and I am the rib of the High Priest over the whole house of Israel.
Sons and daughters of Zion. This is our midweek teaching.
Yes, it is.
Grab that King James.
All right, now.
But first and foremost, we want to give a shout out to the whole family. Happy midweek teaching, Israel.
Teaching family.
All right. Now, my brother and sister, now we're gonna do a teaching, but it's gonna be in a different format tonight, okay? And as always, we ask you guys to think about the reading, mm-hmm. think about what you are reading and saying,
mm-hmm.
and we know that
if you are Hebrew,
the Most High will give you a clear understanding.
That's the catch.
All right. Now that being said, let us go forward. We're gonna be coming from the book of Luke, starting out, and we're going to be dealing with some current events that are transpiring right now, and we want to keep you guys, you know, abreast of what's going on. Okay,
mm-hmm.
All right. Now we're gonna show you some stuff, and I want you guys to think about it, because they want to treat us like slaves. Mm-hmm.
Well, their new president does.
Yeah.
He wants to make it great again. Go back.
But we're going to show y'all here, you know, that the New Testament is nothing but a roadmap to slavery.
It's Master's Guidebook.
That's what it is. It's a guidebook for the black people to slavery. Now let's start here with chapter 6. Now, let's start with verse 27 and read down to 36. Right. Now, let's read that.
27.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Luke, the 6th chapter.
Hold but on. I say unto you,
uh-huh.
which hear,
uh-huh.
love your enemy.
Uh-huh. Y'all hear that?
Do good to them which hate you.
See that?
Sounds good so far to me.
Mm-hmm. Y'all think about this for now, and look at what's transpiring today now.
Bless them that curse you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and pray for them which despitefully use you.
Now, this is what the Christians do today. I'm talking about the black motherfuckers.
Wonderful thing.
That's I'm talking about the black ones. No matter what the white man do to you, mm-hmm. you still revert back to this bullshit right here.
Yeah.
I mean, how long is this bullshit gonna last? How long is y'all gonna keep on being the last part of the cow come across the fence? I ain't talking about his tail, I'm talking about his
ass. They starting to leave that part on one side of the fence. They just crossing over. They don't want them. They don't want nothing to do with them.
I'm so tired of seeing black people, you know, people of color making an ass out of themselves.
Falling for the okey-doke.
Just like that fucking Ray Lewis and Kanye West. Those are the two stupidest motherfuckers I ever seen put on a pair of shoes. And I mean that.
Just worthless.
They are some worthless motherfuckers, and I said that when them bastards first went to the White House to see him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not talking about now, but I'm gonna talk about the ass now too.
Mm-hmm.
Let's keep on.
And unto him that smiteth thee,
uh-huh.
on the one cheek.
Mm-hmm.
You know this is your cheeks, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
These aren't the cheeks he's talking about.
That's
not
right.
These are what y'all call cheeks.
Mm-hmm.
These are the cheeks. Because
mm-hmm.
I'm going to show y'all how he talks about the cheek with which hand he uses.
Mm-hmm.
Offer also the other cheek.
Mm-hmm.
And him that taketh away thy cloak.
Mm-hmm.
Forbid not to take thy cloak away. Huh? Because God said eye for eye and
mm-hmm.
tooth for tooth.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to tell you, do it my way.
Mm-hmm.
Give to every man
mm-hmm.
that asketh of thee.
Mm-hmm.
And of him that taketh away thy goods, ask them not again.
Now my question to any of the motherfucking Christians out there, y'all let somebody take something from you, what you gonna do? You gonna stand there and let them take it? Hell no. But see, but y'all don't live by y'all writing.
They don't live by it because it's bullshit. It's the stupidest shit you ever read in your life.
Y'all don't live by it because it's nothing more than a bunch of bullshit.
Bunch of bullshit.
Let's keep on.
And as ye would that men should do to you. Now, you know, baby, this is my favorite verse.
Talk to him.
I want y'all to read this and hear it for the first time. Now, listen to what it says. And as ye would that men should do to you, do ye also to them likewise. But wait. You can't stop. You can't let that roll.
No.
Because he just told you, upsie bug.
Sure did.
Don't do a goddamn
don't do
thing
nothing
to them.
Bless
when
them
they do all they shit to
bless
you.
Bless them. As a matter of fact, he smacked you on one side of your ass, turn the other side
give
to him.
Give him your other side. Huh? If they take your cloak away from you, don't you do nothing about
it. Give it to him.
But this bitch just told you to do also to them
what they do to you.
Even though this is the homosexual spin on it, but still, when y'all Christians read it, you read it as if they've been good to me, Duke. He didn't say good.
No, he didn't.
Make sure I'm right on this thing. And as ye would that men, and as ye would that men should do to you.
Do ye
also
to them
likewise.
Now, how can that be? And the son of a bitch just said up there,
you couldn't do and don't do.
As a matter of fact, just tie your hands and just let them have their way with you. That's what he said in so many words. Let's keep on.
For if ye love them which love you, then think
what they
have ye. For sinners also love those that love them. What? Wait.
Talk to
wait
him.
Wait, Israel. He said, for if ye love them which love you. Okay. Even a dog got enough goddamn motherfucking sense to know if your black ass is kicking the fuck out of him, he don't love that.
He sure don't.
Even a dog knows that.
And he'll bite you.
He'll take so much of that shit and he'll turn on your ass.
That's right.
But you fucking Christians who don't live by none of this bullshit because it don't make no goddamn sense.
He sure don't.
He just told you that if the sinner loves those that love them, well, goddamn it, hell yeah, the sinner got sense. If somebody loves you, you love them back.
That's just like in a household where you call yourself, use a holy roller going to church every time the damn doors open. Then you got children at home that don't go to church, so you don't love them, but you call them sinners.
See, except so, if they're giving you money.
So there's a contradiction they do, isn't it? I thought so.
But that sinner loves your ass, your Christian ass. Just stupid. Just stupid.
That's right.
And if ye do good to them which do good to you, common sense, what think have ye? For sinners also do even the same, because sinners got motherfucking sense.
They sure do. They so do.
You don't see no sinner talking about, he took my car, he stole my car, bust the windows out, and bro, I gotta buy him a car. Ain't no sinner no fool.
No.
The sinner gonna be looking for that bastard so he can either do the same thing or get his ass.
That's right. One of the two. One or two. Let's keep them.
And if ye lend to them of whom ye hope to receive. What the fucking word lend mean?
Well, one thing about this is when you go to the motherfucking bank, now, the one that runs the bank, 9 times out of 10, he's a Christian too. And you could borrow some money from them and don't pay them back.
What does the word lend mean?
That's what you do.
You don't lend anybody anything you want back.
That's
you
right.
Give.
You give it to them.
You give. So you cannot say you lent them something if you're not expecting it back.
That's right.
What think had ye? For sinners also lend to sinners to receive as much again. Well, goddamn fucking shit, yes. We told you, sinners got sense.
That's right.
But love ye your enemies. And do good and lend. What? Hoping for nothing again.
What a fool. What a fool. But nah. Ask y'all, ask any of those motherfucking Christians out there that got any sense at all. They don't abide by this. They don't.
Not a one.
They don't abide by this. They give you, and the thing about you is,
fucking Christians will hound you down to hell for their dollar.
You ask the motherfucker for something, boy, they so tight till they squeak when they walk, they be crying like hell.
And I tell you, God told me to do it.
Yeah.
Well, God told you to do it. God didn't tell you to ask for it back. That's if right. You. I just can't take it. Anyway, this is y'all's bullshitting word.
Let's keep going.
And your reward shall be great. And it's a bunch of them died and went straight to I don't know where, waiting on that fucking stupid reward after doing all this shit.
It ain't came yet.
And ye shall be the children of the highest. The highest what?
Yeah.
The children of the highest what?
Just because you lent somebody something.
The highest what?
You have to think about it now. Y'all Christians out there, just because you lent somebody something and then hope for them not to pay you back. That gives you the right to be a child of the highest.
The highest what though? The highest God.
Highest hill.
The highest mountain. The highest ladder you can buy. Gonna be the highest? What highest?
Mm-hmm.
For his kind unto, because that's a little H, you do see that. So if he was speaking about the creator, that'd be a capital H.
Mm-hmm.
Kind unto the unthankful. And to the evil. Stop right there. Stop right there. Stop
that
right there.
That makes no sense at all.
Did not he just tell you that this highest is going to give you the greatest?
Mm-hmm.
But it tells you down here, he's kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. Not your ass.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't it say, because he is kind to this fool that would give all they got and lend all they got and not look for nothing back.
But not only that, you don't even have to abide by what he told you to do. And God's, and the
God's
Most High is kind, is good, and still going to come and find you. So why even do it? It makes no sense.
Because he's only good to the sinner, the unthankful, the evil.
He says, for he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. Now, why are y'all giving up all y'all shit? Well, I know you're not, but y'all supposed to.
We know the Christians are.
But why would you do that? And thus, the highest kind is going to come toward you anyway. I mean, he's double-tongued. But anyway, let's go to Matthew. Matthew the fifth chapter. Let's go there. Let's move along here real quick here. Matthew the fifth chapter. Let me know when you get there.
Okay, where you gonna start?
Let's start with verse 43, and we're gonna read just a few of them, and then we're gonna bounce around here in Matthew, because I wanna lay a foundation here to show you guys how fucked up this bullshit is and how it has brainwashed people of color. And people of color, they will allow other nations just to put their foot in their ass, and then you just take it with a smile.
Yeah, because that's what you're used to.
You do.
You take it with a smile. Get your stuff from.
And then you think that they love you, and they don't. I remember a while back, I told you guys about something happened on the job. This black guy, he went over to the boss's house. He invited him over to his house, and they sit down, you know, and talked and drank a couple beers together. He came back on the job. My boss, he loved me. He loved me. He invited me. Motherfucker, are you out your mind? Are you out your mind? All the man did was drink a beer with you. He never told you at any time that he loved you. The motherfucker got mad with me, but I didn't give a damn because it told him the truth.
And why are you so hounding for his love?
Yeah.
Because you've been brainwashed into believing that if the cattle loves you, then it makes you special.
Me. He loved me. No, he don't. He never told you that at any time. Let's keep on.
Verse 43, y'all, in Matthew 5. Ye have heard that it hath been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thine enemy. Well, let's look at that. Who's your neighbor?
Yeah.
When God gave this law to Moses, because see, this was never given to the world.
He sure didn't.
This had nothing to do with the world. That law does not belong to the world.
It sure don't.
He told family members who lived next door to one another, because nobody lived there. It was all allowed to live with the family.
They were separated.
Love the one that lives next door to you, your neighbor, family,
that's right,
your brother, your sister,
yes,
cousin, uncle, auntie, great grandmother, grandfather. Love them because those are your neighbors. Then he told them, hate the enemy.
And see, let me interject with that. See, because if you look at the writing here, and just think about it, those that is in your immediate family, those that live next to you, is like a clan. It is like a cluster of family members living side by side. All right? This is what he's talking about.
That's right.
But now, Jesus tells you to go outside this cluster and love them.
The ones that God is keeping away from
those,
you.
Those that are outside the family, those are your enemies. Now, I'm going to show you in the Most High's holy word where your brother can become your enemy, but he is not like the enemy that is outside the family.
Not the same.
It's not. And Israel became God's enemy also when they what? Disobeyed his word. They have became his enemy.
Just
so
like
he punished them.
We made our bed in hell. We're in hell. Y'all got to wash all your Christian understanding of hell away. You have got to get yourself clean and clear from all that bullshit you've been taught. Your bed is in hell.
And like a lot of them try to teach the word, you know, well, how can God say that he wants you to love your neighbor and hate your enemy, you know, over in the Old Testament, and then Jesus talking about over in the New Testament, love your enemy, and then there's scriptures in the Old Testament also tell you to love your enemy, but you know who he's talking about? He's talking about your family members. He's talking about your brother. He's not talking about somebody on the outside, because I'm going to show you what the Most High did to Israel's enemy.
And just like Solomon, baby.
Y'all know the story.
Just like Solomon. He told him, I'm going to bless you. Why? Because you didn't ask me to destroy your enemy. Meaning, your own brother. Because, listen, he was king.
That's right.
He had many that didn't love him. He had to make tough decisions and rule and govern. And a lot of folks didn't like him.
David said it also. David said that it was those that was in his own household.
God never dealt with no outsiders. He didn't give a fuck about them and didn't want you to give a fuck about them.
So didn't. And the only time God dealt with their motherfucking ass is when he carried our ancestors in there to take their shit.
That's the only time.
That's right. Other than that, he gave them wisdom and knowledge to build these cities and do all these things. Yes, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof and all those that dwell therein. That's a true statement.
Thank you.
But he delegate them spirits to go out and teach them, and they build them the dynasties and these big places, you know, in the biblical time. And then the Most High sent Israel in there and just take the shit.
That's right.
That's why he says I'm gonna give you cities that you didn't even build. That's right. Take it. Let's keep on.
44. Now listen closely. But I say unto you, fuck the living God.
Yep, that's what he's saying.
He don't tell you shit. I'm running this goddamn
show. That's right.
Love your enemy. Bless them that curse you.
Now we're not talking about how Western civilization had to fuck your mind up, saying, you know, damn shit, asshole. That's not cursing. As we said in other videos, those are words of expression. All right? Cursing is when you wish bad ill on them. Somebody.
Like we have done. We have actually done that.
I hope you die. Or you speak a word towards them, and ask the Most High to send his destroyer, which is why I did do that for some of them, that's been messing around. Yeah, we done that already. But that is a curse. Then the book of Deuteronomy, the only thing you got to do is go over and read it. But now you let Western civilization tell you something else.
Foul language.
These are words of expression.
Dog vulgar, goddamn it, you're speaking dog, you uneducated idiot.
That's right. Well, let's keep on.
Do good to them that hate you.
Ain't that something? Now, I'm going to show you in the Most High's holy
word. They'll die before that happens for me.
Where the Most High told his people that if your brother was your enemy, to do good to him and stuff like that. But don't wish a curse on your enemy. And he's talking about your brother. Mm-hmm. Not your enemy outside of the family.
That is your enemy, goddammit. Then you don't have no enemies.
Because of y'all remember the Most High said, I love Jacob. And what else?
Esau.
He said, Esau, I hate. They were two brothers. Came out the same womb.
And Jesus said, I'll tell God he better love Esau.
Well, let's keep on.
Alright. Then he tells you that this is where he gets you. Because you ain't got the authority to do this in the first place. You can do that other bullshit if you want to, if you're that damn dumb. But you don't have the authority to do this. And pray for them which despitefully use you. To who?
Yeah. To who?
What God is listening to some bullshit like that?
Not only that. The out of all the families, could nobody pray but Levi, children of Israel. That's all. Nobody else could.
And since he knew Israel was in this hole, they wrote it like this.
But he leaves y'all. Why y'all think your prayers hadn't been answered?
Thank you.
Why? And listen, if anything transpired in your life, it was the Most High.
The Most High that did it.
Things
are predestined.
They are.
They're already written.
They're already predestined.
But then there's some things that you have to ask him for through a priest. Alright, he says, and persecute you. So in other words, they can come in and kill all your kids, which they did do. They can come in and rape your wife, which they did do. They can come in and burn your house down, which they did do. They can come in and hang you from a tree, which they did do. You're supposed to love them.
Mm-hmm.
That ye may be the children of your father. Who is the fucking father?
Yeah, who is?
They are the children of their father if they was born.
But you gotta do all this little stupid ass shit, just like Lennon, and hoping on that you don't get it back and all this bullshit to be a child of the highest. I mean, can't y'all guys see that this is nothing more than a copy?
So that means God ain't got no kids.
Because this is Western civilization teaching you. This here is a roadmap, and as a matter of fact,
to slavery.
As the rib said, this is the fucking handbook.
Handbook for master.
This is master's handbook.
Keep them niggas in control.
And I'm a show it to you. I'm a show it to you. But many times. A lot of them just read over and don't even see it. It's right in the pages. He tells you that this here is master's handbook to slavery.
Now, think about it. Why does this stuff work for white people? Because white people live in their own communities.
That's right.
White people are family. Mm-hmm. And white people don't let black folks in. If
that's
that
right.
Any sense.
Mm-hmm.
So when they go by these stupid rules and regulations that he has made up, it works for them. Because that is him talking to his people. It's when you fools try it.
And he gonna show you that there is a distinct difference between you and them. I'm gonna show it to you in Jesus' writing. I'm not lying. I'm not making this up. I'm gonna show it to you. But you know what though? Them damn fools that's in Christianity, they can't even see it.
They see it.
They can't even see it. And he makes a dividing line between you and them.
They're not chosen.
I'm going to show it to you.
They're not chosen.
Let's keep on.
Your Father which is in heaven.
Uh-huh.
For he maketh his son, lowercase, to rise on the evil and on the good. And sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust.
Isn't that something?
So what does they have? Why do they have to bring them in? When he's so that's to convince them fools.
Yeah.
I mean, rain gonna fall on everybody.
Everybody.
Even fall on the graves of the dead.
It's raining,
he
fool.
He said nothing. He said a goddamn thing.
And not only that, if the rain falls on the just as well as the unjust, why would you even follow behind this bullshit? You still gonna get your rain.
Maybe fell on because they had no umbrella.
I mean, it's right in the pages. All you gotta do is just see that you do have an option here.
It's just stupid. Stupid.
You got an option, but you don't even see it. You so, ooh, I'm scared to go to hell. Man, that's nothing but a bunch of bullshit. Let's keep on.
Anyway, wait. 48.
Yeah, let the 48.
For if ye love them which love you, what reward have ye? Do not even the publicans the same? And if ye salute your brother only, what do ye more than others? Do not even the publicans do so? Well, of course the publicans had sense. They knew to salute their brother. Yo, dumb ass dumb. That's why when you go places and you so picking and a grinning at white people and saying hi, and they walk past your stupid ass. Because they don't give a fuck about you. They're not concerned about you. You can be on your goddamn job and look up, they got their head turned the other way, so they don't have to speak to you.
Right.
And you know it's the truth.
And you know, I have even heard some of them in the break room talking about the black news newscaster at 5 o'clock. They holler about, you know, talking to one another. You know, that's not pleasant to see, you know, in the afternoon when you get off from work. And guess what they did? In the city I live in, they moved that black motherfucker.
And they got rid of him.
Sure did. And they put a white woman there.
Sure.
And then paid her 3 times or 4 times the money.
Told her salary on the air. I'm like, there was what?
Six figures.
And guess what? The coon was married to a white girl. They don't get no shit about that.
Don't care about that. So don't. What a fool.
He gonna say, you want 48?
Yeah, let's do 48.
Be ye therefore perfect. Even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. So, man. Wait a minute. Whoa, stop the presses. Hold on.
I mean, somebody need to hit the bricks quick.
He just told you to throw out everything the Father said and told you to do in order to be this so-called perfect. But yet, if you be that way, you'll be perfect like the Father. How could that make the Father perfect? If he gonna change and do all the bullshit he said do.
I mean, it just goes back and forth. It's nothing but a bunch of jibber jabber bullshit, just like I always say. Now let's go back. Let's stay in that book and let's look at from 38 to 42. Let's read that in Matthew 5:38-42.
All right, let me get up here to 38.
Ye
have heard that it hath been said. An eye for an eye.
Now this is what the Most High told Moses. Now this is what the Most High told Moses. Yeah.
And a tooth for a tooth.
Yeah. Now the Most High told Moses this after they had exited Egypt.
Sure did.
Yeah, he did.
Laying the law down.
Yeah, he did.
This is how it's gonna be amongst family.
I'm gonna show it to you. Keep on.
But I say unto you, fuck the living God.
That's what he
don't
saying.
Don't pay him no goddamn attention. I'm running this show.
That's what he's saying.
That ye resist not evil. Oh, evil, take me, baby. Whatever you want to do to me, I'm here, evil. Oh, I resist you not.
Y'all,
goddamn,
y'all
stupid.
Know what the Most High always said. Now, even in his writing here, even in his writing, I forget where it said. I think it might be over in Timothy somewhere. But he said, "Resist evil and do good." That's what Jesus said. It's in his writing. I can't pull it up right now and tell you verbatim what book it's in. But baby, sitting there, he said, "Resist evil and do good." Now he telling you, don't resist it. Keep on. Keep on.
Resist not evil.
Mm-hmm.
But whosoever shall smite thee on thy right cheek, turn to him the other also.
Man, I tell you, you know, we got to teach this, but I tell you, I hate going through, you know, this old bullshit. I do. I mean, honestly, this is just nothing but garbage.
But we got to show them why black
garbage.
Folk act the way black folk act.
And they are so stupid.
Oh, and I know that since y'all have been awakened, the things that you see literally make you want to regurgitate.
Yep.
Because you see them and you think to yourself, Lord, have mercy.
They're so proud and pompous.
If they only knew what I knew.
Oh, they are proud. They got a pompous attitude. Oh, they think that they duty don't stink, boy.
Mm-mm-mm.
Oh, they're something else.
And if any man will sue thee, am I right?
That's what it's saying.
Did he say if any man will sue thee at the law?
That's what he's saying.
And take away thy coat, let him hide thy cloak also.
And that's,
so would y'all even go to court to be sued for?
But naked now.
He wants you to be out there with
nothing. But now how many of you Christians will abide by this?
He didn't say if he sues you in a just cause.
No, he didn't.
If he's right. He said if he wants your coat, you take everything off and just strip down and give him everything.
I mean, I tell you, boy, this is so stupid. But see, I think that we are getting, you know, some headway with some of these Christians.
No, some of these Christians are thinking.
I do.
They thinking.
I really believe
they still do that because I gotta keep my faith.
They see it.
They starting to see.
They see nothing
they
but a bunch of bullshit.
They starting to see it.
Nothing but a bunch of bullshit. Let's keep on.
And if any man will I just did that one. Let's do 41.
41.
And whosoever shall compel thee to go a mile. Go with him twain. Why?
Yeah.
If a stupid ass motherfucker asks you to walk a mile with him, what the fuck you got to go two for?
Why? Shit, I ain't.
He said, I want to go a mile.
I wouldn't, man.
If you want to go a mile, if you choose to go, you could go. Why you got to go two?
But I'm going to tell y'all, Israel, when you're in that bullshit and you're trying to live it, I mean, people make an ass out of you. They will. They make a plumb ass out of you because you're trying to live this bullshit.
You're trying to live the bullshit.
And they just use you. They just trample over you. I mean, they just do you all kind of ways. And you say, oh, that's about the Lord going to get a man. Shit. Boy, I tell you, boy, motherfucker better not fuck with me now. I'm telling you.
Oh, no.
I'm telling you, I ain't taking no shit, boy. Years ago, I took a lot of shit, boy. And that shit, boy,
the dumbest Christians on the planet. Giving everything away. Giving everything.
And I'm asking the Most High.
Calling people up because we looked at them. Come get our furniture. Mm-hmm. And we'll give it away to this young girl that was going to a church we went to. Mm-hmm. And, you know, her and her kids were in a lot of need, we thought.
Gave her,
but gave
real
her
wood.
Our beautiful
real
furniture.
Wood. Shit.
And shit.
I think it was red oak.
We gave it away to her and went out like fools and bought us some more. But it was just the things that we did.
Yeah.
Now, I love blessing my family. I gave my family something that I wanted them to have. I called them up and told them, come get it.
Yep.
Because I wanted them to have that furniture. But that other shit was in Christianity that we did. And, I mean, we used to give away clothes and shoes. And I would buy my husband expensive things because he was a so-called preacher.
Mm-hmm.
And doing, I got to stand before the people. And somebody would say, oh, man, I like them shoes. Oh, man, where you get them? Or where you get? And we go, well, we got to give them away. They want them. It's just stupid.
Yeah, stupid ass shit. I tell you, this book here, Bob, will make you be a complete asshole.
It will. Out of
it will. And like I said, you know, I just wish the Most High, you know, give me the opportunity to go back, you know, about 45 years or 50 years and straighten some shit out, boy. I do. Oh man, I tell you, I would be so happy.
But he did all that to show us, because I'm telling you, without those experiences, we would not have anything to compare this to.
Yeah, that's true.
We were in hell. Being a Christian was literal hell.
Man, I tell you, I think about it now, boy. But anyway, the Most High gonna take care of it. But let's keep on
42
going.
Says, give to him that asked him, mm-hmm, thee, and from him that would borrow of thee, turn not thou away.
So if everybody come and ask you for something,
You gotta give it.
And guess what? Pretty soon,
you ain't got shit.
You ain't got nothing.
And they ain't gotta expect nothing back, cause they ain't got to give it back.
That's right. Now how much sense does that make? It doesn't make any sense,
man,
at all.
Man, I went over and asked Jimbo for $100. He gave it to me, man. You better go ask Jimbo.
Yeah.
Jimbo just got his paycheck to pay his rent. Knock, 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 knock. Jimbo, man, I need $100. I'm a Christian. I've got to give it to you. Now, ain't no fucking Christians like that. But this is how he says.
This is a simple formula here. If you keep pouring some water out of a cup and don't ever put no water back in that cup, that damn cup gonna soon be empty.
It'll be empty.
That's just the way it is. I mean, that is a simple way of saying it. Now, how in the hell can this shit work? How can that work? It don't work. It just makes you a damn fool. Let's keep on.
All right, but we did 43. We started with 43. Okay. So we know we've covered all that. We've shown you
all right, now
let's all go the foolishness
now let's go
of
to,
chapter 5.
Now, let's go to Exodus chapter 21. Let's look at that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Now, I'm going to show y'all here what the Most High says here. But Jesus says, forget about that. This is the law that the Most High gave to Moses.
Started what, 22?
Yeah, you can read that.
If men strive,
mm-hmm,
and hurt a woman with child.
Uh-huh. They're fighting.
So that her fruit depart from her.
Talking about her. But baby, that's in the inside of the belly.
And yet no mischief follow.
Mm-hmm.
He shall be surely punished.
That's right.
According as the woman's husband will lay upon him.
That's right. Man, you done made my wife.
That's eye for eye stuff.
You done made my wife have a damn
my baby.
Miscarriage. Oh, man, she just home now.
He shall pay as the judges
determine.
Mm-hmm. And if any mischief follow,
uh-huh,
then thou shalt give
life for life.
The other cheek.
Life for life.
His cloak.
Life for life. Right in the pages.
But I say, fuck everything.
That's right.
The Most High God.
That's right.
Said.
Mm-hmm. That what he's saying? Life for life. Shit. But and that's what it was when we was amongst one another. But over here,
Most High don't play, y'all.
But over here in Egypt, they take your life and that's the end of it.
And that's so why they don't want you to govern yourself.
Mm-hmm.
These laws are the reason why they don't want you to govern yourself.
Mm-hmm.
They want to govern you because you will take care of the problem.
Mm-hmm.
See, they don't want them black mothers taking mm-hmm. care of them children properly mm-hmm. because they know they will keep them in line.
Mm-hmm.
So they take them away from you and they brainwash them for 8 hours in a so-called school, and then you don't have no time to pretty much train your children because mm-hmm. they fed all their bullshit into
that's
them.
That's right. They got them longer than you got them. Let's keep on.
24 says,
mm-hmm.
I for eye.
It's right there in the pages.
Tooth for tooth.
Mm-hmm. See that?
Hand for hand.
It's right there in the pages.
Foot for foot.
But Jesus says, but I see. Mm-hmm. Y'all can't see that? I'm talking to the Christians that's out there. Y'all can't see that? Oh, boy, I tell you. Y'all, Y'all can see that. Y'all some sad fuckers. Mm-hmm. Y'all some sad fuckers.
We don't have to see it because that was done away with. We have a Christ and we know he liveth.
So in other
Our
words.
Our Savior liveth.
So in other words, they did away with God then.
Yeah, they did.
Boy, I tell you.
They don't need for God. They got a Savior in Christ.
Mm-hmm. Y'all gonna see what's going to happen. At the end of days.
Thank you.
Let's keep on. Now let's go to 1 Peter.
All right. Maybe we'll start.
Let's start with 18. Yeah, let's start with 18.
Here we go, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Servants.
Uh-huh.
Be subject to your master.
Right there. Can y'all see that he's making a distinguish between you and them?
Mm-hmm.
He's making a difference between you and them.
Because you know you ain't master.
You ain't master. It's right in the pages. He's making a difference between you and the white man.
Now check this out. Check this. Wait. He gets even better, baby. He gets even better.
But y'all some fools.
He said, with all fear.
Mm-mm-mm.
You know that reverence you
mm-hmm.
would give the Most High God?
Mm-hmm.
Give it a master.
And see, the thing about it, if y'all didn't, if they didn't apply with this right here.
It beat the shit out of
okay, master boy, he putting that whip all over his ass.
That's how some of y'all became Christian.
Beat it in you.
They beat that
beat it in you.
Bitch in you.
Okay, master. Yeah.
And we can prove it too mm-hmm. by his next words.
Listen to it. It's right in the page. I'll tell you, I'm going to show it to you.
Not only the good and gentle, mm-hmm. as if there was any of those.
Yeah. All of them put their foot in our ass.
But also to the forward.
See that? I mean, can't you guys see that he's making a distinction different between you and them? He's telling you to be obedient to him.
But whatever
he says, whatever master says, master's
so
right.
Christian, what happened to that? what happened? These are your words. This is your Bible that you your New Testament that you go by.
Mm, mm, mm.
What happened to that?
Boy, I tell you, boy.
So if you're giving master all fear, you ain't even fearing a Jesus.
You sure not?
Cause you ain't got no fear left. You don't give it all to master.
You don't give it all to master. It's right there in the pages. I ain't making this up.
Do I hate this shit? You better goddamn have fucking.
I ain't making this up. And we see these motherfucking coons every day, even on the job and everywhere else. We see the motherfucking coons. You know, oh boy, they will sell your ass out in a heartbeat. They will. Trying to make
like that make master happy. Pat a little puppy on the head.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
You done a good thing,
yeah.
Boy.
Mm-hmm. Do it all the time. They do it all the time. Trying to make the motherfucker love you.
Just like Moses, when them two nigger coons saw what he did to the Egyptian.
Yeah. Moses had to... Moses.
Knowing them some of the same cockfucks that probably beat they black ass.
Moses had to run for his life. And that's how it is today now. These black motherfuckers, boy, y'all don't know. Boy, some motherfuckers out there, boy, that will tell on your motherfucking ass, boy. If you do anything, don't you let nobody know about it but you and the Most High. Don't you even let your dog know about it. Let's keep on.
For this is thankworthy.
Mm, mm, mm.
If a man of conscience toward God endures grief. Suffering wrongfully.
Mm-mm-mm.
Huh?
Isn't that something?
If you can take it when you know you right, and they doing it just cause you right,
mm-hmm.
use it special.
Mm-hmm.
It's special to God.
Telling you that he can put that whip all across your motherfucking ass. And you sit there, boy, and you take it like, take it.
Cause this is what God likes. This is what God wants a master.
And how stupid is it? Even if you ain't done nothing, even the master just want to come out there and whoop your ass for GP. You take it and enjoy it.
He lost the card game. So, where's me a nigga?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Here's how he is. beat me for Jesus.
Mm-hmm. How stupid.
And we were fools like that too.
Fools, fools, fools. And then these stupid motherfuckers come on the page talking about, oh, you're going to hell, boy.
I'd rather go than where them fucking Christians thinking they going. I'm in hell, dumbass. I don't want to go nowhere no goddamn motherfucking Christians going.
And they read right over this bullshit and can't even see it. Can't you see that the author of this book, he's writing a separation between you and them? He's talking about two people, two different people here.
One and over the other.
You on the short end of the stick.
Thank you. Leash.
Let's keep going.
For what glory is it?
Mm-hmm.
If when ye be buffeted for your faults. So if I beat your ass because you did wrong, you know, glory in that. Ye shall take it patiently. But if when ye do well and suffer for it, Massa, I does this everything you says is, can you beat me now?
Boy, I tell you. Y'all see this, man, I tell you. I mean, even though I know we got a teacher, but that shit, it hurts me. I mean, it does.
You take it patiently.
That shit hurts.
This is acceptable with God.
Now, y'all know that shit ain't right. Y'all know that shit ain't right.
They don't know it.
Here's a motherfucker beat you when you try to run and leave for your freedom. But when you out there done plowed the field all day, huh? In 105 degree weather, and then you come in and it's supper time, and he jump on you and start wailing on your ass because you plowed the field all day.
You did it just like I wanted it, boy. Let me beat your ass.
And that's what God will accept. That. How stupid.
That's what.
Oh boy, I tell you how stupid you motherfuckers are. Let's keep on.
Let's go
to Ephesians 6. Yeah, let's go. Let's read from verse 1 all the way down there, 8.
Okay, let's see here. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. You won't have time.
See,
you're too busy with Massa.
Now, see, he's softening your ass up right now.
It's how he trick you.
Yeah, he's softening you up now. Because he got something for you. He got some bullshit for you. Keep on.
For this is right.
Mm-hmm.
Honor thy father and mother.
That is Old Testament scripture. But the rest of it is not.
Because it tells your brother Luke to hate him. Anyway, we ain't going there. Which is the first commandment with promise. That's a fucking lie. That is a lie.
The first commandment is what? Thou shalt not what?
Have no other gods. Big dumbass bastard. That it may be well with thee. And thou mayest live long on the earth.
Now he told them way back there that if they did obey their parents,
days will be prolonged.
That your days will be prolonged upon the land which the Lord thy God has given
thee.
Huh? Not this
no place else.
Land over here. Not in Russia. Not in China. I mean, y'all have to. Let's keep on.
All right. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nature and admonish admiration.
Admiration
of the Lord. Servants. Be obedient to them that are your masters. Now stop right there. Stop. He done gave you all this ice cream and cake and candy and cookies about how you do your parents. But now you get ready to wash all that away. Because he's getting ready to deal with you and Massa. So Massa tells you to disobey your parents.
Gotta do it. You gotta do it. But y'all see that this is nothing more. I mean, we're trying to get the Christians, the one that's on the fence, you know, to get off the fence, you know, and drop that bullshit.
That's our family. All the rest of y'all stay wherever you want to stay. We're just trying to get to Israel. We're trying to get to the chosen. We're trying to get to the Levites and the Judites that are here under this hell, mm-hmm. because the other ones are under a different hell, wherever mm-hmm. they are, wherever mm-hmm. he scattered you. And hopefully you can get to this too. Mm-hmm. But we know right here mm-hmm. what took place on this plop of hell.
This plop of dirt, that's right.
Which we're going to deal with a little bit later on. Mm-hmm. Anyway. It says that ye that are your masters according to the flesh. Mm-hmm. What does that mean?
I have no idea.
Did he mean according to the? And but I tell you now, or I say, what flesh? Be obedient according to the flesh.
I guess he's talking about the master that have flesh on them, but all of them had flesh, skin on them.
Yeah, what
I
mean,
I don't know what he's saying. The dead ones I have no idea. I don't know what this is.
Okay, so we'll work on according to the flesh because I know what it means. With fear and trembling.
Mm-hmm. See that?
In singleness of heart. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What the fuck that means either.
But my question is that as long as you fear and tremble before master, then that's what he wants.
Because see, Master did not like girls as much as he did berries.
But y'all see,
getting to that flesh thing.
Y'all see, this here is so fucked up. It is. Come on, let's go ahead.
Didn't they get them boys and they didn't want the girls. They wanted wine.
That was Joel.
Wine for the girlies.
In the book of Joel, the third chapter.
They sold them for wine, but for the boy.
Use the boy for a whore, for a harlot. Yeah. You see, that's why, you know, I see all of them. They all are homosexuals. All of them. I don't give a fuck what they say. They can be married and have children. They still go both ways.
Now, for some of y'all that ain't never seen a homosexual, go to church. Most of them start with pastor.
And see, I'm going to tell y'all something, too.
They just buried one here not too long ago.
These people of color, when they start fucking around with these Caucasians and shit, they bring their other shit back into our community. Shit that we don't even be thinking about.
Don't know nothing about.
And they bring that shit back in because with them, they don't draw a line in the sand and say, well, okay, I ain't doing that. Anytime you fuck around with those that go outside and they come back in, they got a bag of tricks.
Sure know.
And sure will. Let's keep on now.
As unto Christ,
mm-hmm.
not with eye service,
mm-hmm.
as man pleasers,
mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
but as the servants of Christ. Well, mm-hmm. there were men pleasers, mm-hmm. as little Dick, mm-hmm. his name Peter.
Peter, yeah.
Doing the will of God, mm-hmm. from the heart,
mm-hmm.
with good will. Doing service,
mm-hmm.
as to the Lord, mm-hmm. and not to men,
mm-hmm.
knowing that whatsoever good thing any man doeth, the same shall he receive of the Lord.
Okay.
Well, that can't be so, because when we just read the other one, mm-hmm. he told him not to expect nothing.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Whether he be bond or free.
Now, that means so.
So all them Luciferians that done sacrificed all that I had to sacrifice to do for this bitch, you didn't have to because mm-hmm. what he said he gonna do it for you whether you bond mm-hmm. or free.
That's right. Now let's show you how the Most High calls his people enemies. Let's go to Malachi chapter 1. I'm gonna get Malachi chapter 1, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna do that, and then I want you to go to Deuteronomy chapter 20. All
right.
Okay. Now I'm gonna do Malachi chapter 1. Look what it says here. It says, "The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi."
Mm-hmm.
"I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us?
Mm.
Was not Esau Jacob's brother?" Question. Yeah, he's a brother.
Yeah, he was. Mm-hmm.
"Saith the Lord, yet I love Jacob, and I hated Esau, and laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragon of the wilderness." See that? The Most High, he makes his people his enemy. And Job even said that how the Most High was doing him.
Yep.
Job said, you have made me your enemy.
Put a fence around me.
You have made me your enemy.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's go to Deuteronomy 20, verses 10 through 17.
All right.
Now, let's look at that. Now, I'm going to show you how the Most High rose with those outside his family. That is his enemy.
Okay. All right, here we go. Verse 10 says, when thou comest nigh mm-hmm. unto a city to fight against it.
Now, this the Most High now.
Give them your cloak, sword, knives, staves.
Not so.
Hand them everything.
Not so.
Oh, well, they weren't Christian.
Not so.
Then proclaim peace unto it.
Trick them. Trick them. Watch it.
And it shall be.
Mm-hmm.
If it make the answer of peace
mm-hmm.
and open unto thee, then it shall be mm-hmm. that all the people that is found therein shall be, what did I say? Tributaries unto thee. And they shall serve thee.
Mm-hmm.
And if it will make no peace with thee,
mm-hmm.
but will make war against thee,
mm-hmm.
then thou shalt besiege.
Take it.
So in other words, they open up like they would as Christians and mm-hmm. say, well, come on in. We would want to fix you something to mm-hmm. eat. Y'all, you're bringing peace. Take it.
Mm-hmm.
But if they don't act like Christians and give it to you,
mm-hmm.
take it.
Mm-hmm.
Either way.
That's right.
All right. He says, and it shall be, if it make the, wait a minute, no. Let's, where we at now? We're on?
It shall
12? Did we finish this one here?
Yeah, let's do 12 now.
And the people and found, therein shall, yeah, okay, let's do 12. Mm-hmm. And if it will make no peace with thee,
mm-hmm.
but will make war against thee, then thou shalt besiege it.
Uh-huh.
13. And when the Lord thy God hath delivered it into thine hands,
mm-hmm.
thou shalt smite every male thereof with the edge of the sword.
Mm-hmm. Kill it one of them. See that?
So now y'all starting to get the picture mm-hmm. Framed up for you as to why cattle kills your men.
Mm-hmm.
They know that the Most High is going to kill them.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to kill them. Some of the women and children will live because we've got to have slaves.
Mm-hmm.
So they do that to try to destroy you because they knew that's what the Most High had you doing. All right?
Mm-hmm.
14. But the women
mm-hmm.
and the little ones that we can train mm-hmm. and teach and then take all their understanding away from them as they did us. And all that is in the city,
mm-hmm.
even all the spoil thereof,
mm-hmm.
shalt thou take unto thyself.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me clear this up for you dumb motherfucking black mm-hmm. ass stupid fools.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't tell you to take the cattle as your women.
Mm-hmm.
He was telling you to take them for your women as servants.
Mm-hmm.
Stupid.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I better throw that in because they believe that's what it means.
Mm-hmm.
And eat the spoil of thy enemy,
mm-hmm.
which the Lord thy God hath given thee.
See that?
Thus shalt thou do unto all the cities which are very far off from thee, which are not of the cities of these nations.
See that? He told
all of them.
He told them what you want to do. See that? Go on and take it.
But of the cities of those of these people,
mm-hmm.
which the Lord thy God doeth give thee for an inheritance,
mm-hmm.
thou shalt save alive nothing
mm-hmm.
that breatheth.
See that? See that?
But I say unto you, mm-hmm. let them all live.
Most I said, no, kill every damn one of them.
I said, kill them some of a bitch.
Kill every damn one of them.
Speaking of some of bitches, we'll get to that later.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, 17.
Mm-hmm.
But thou shalt utterly destroy them,
mm-hmm.
namely the Hittites, the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, the Jebusites, as the Lord thy God hath commanded thee. He said, kill all of them, but I won't like these that much. Get them special. That they teach you not to do after all their abominations. And that's exactly what Christianity teaches you to do. To abominate against the Most High God.
All the time. All the time. That's all it's about.
Teaches you to be
come against
the white.
Come against the Most High.
Alright. He says, which they have done unto their gods, so should ye sin against the Lord your God.
That's 17?
That's 18.
Okay, that's good enough. Now let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 2. We're going to go there and we're going to start with verses. We got a couple of words here that we may not be able to pronounce.
But couple.
We're going to get as close as we can. Let's start with verse 26.
Alright, let me get down here. Alright, 26. And I sent messengers out of the wilderness to Kedemoth. Unto Shion, king of Heshbon, with words peace saying, let me pass through thy land. I will go along by the highway. I will neither turn unto the right hand nor to the left.
I'm going straight down. I ain't here to bother you. All I want to do is
let me pass through.
Because I'm on a mission. Let's keep on.
Thou shalt sell me meat for money, that I may eat, and give me water for money, that I may drink. Only I pass through on my feet.
All I want to do is pass through.
Let me walk through.
And if you want to send me some water, send me some water. You want to send me some food.
All right. As the children of Esau, which dwell in and the Moabites which dwelt in Ar did unto me. So in other words, they let them pass. He's telling them, they let me pass through. So that's a good word to pass on to you. Until I shall pass over Jordan into the land which the Lord our God giveth us. But Shion, king of Heshbon, would not let us pass by him. For the Lord thy God hardened his spirit and made his heart abstinent that he might deliver him into thy hand as a parent this day.
Now see that? Now we told you guys. Now you guys see. I mean, all through the pages, the Most High can manipulate your mind and make you do any damn thing he wants to. And you won't even know it. You think that you're doing, you know, on your own, I'm making my own mind up. No, you're not. Now, see, now, he made this cat him harden his heart where he wouldn't let him go through so that they can try to fight him, and the Most High going to tell him, take his damn land. As y'all know how we roll, you know, as kids growing up, let's go pick us a fight. That's what he's doing. Keep on.
And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have begun to give Shion and his hand before thee.
Picking a fight with him.
I'm doing this one, boy.
Picking a fight with him. Know why? Cause I'm gonna give you his city. Keep on.
Began to possess that thou mayest inherit his land.
Right there in the pages.
Now I want to say this right quick to
right
Israel.
In the pages.
Some of y'all don't realize a lot of the bullshit that you're dealing with is a part of you getting something that you asked the Most High.
I'm telling you the truth.
You don't want that bullshit to go away because that's God's way of getting what you want.
I went through hell
through him
for I don't know how many years on my job, didn't I?
Yes, baby. Years.
Motherfuckers playing games, boy. I mean, the white boy did. Playing games with me and bullshit and trying to fuck over me, but the most I stayed with me, right? Now, I'm making almost twice the money I was making. But I had to go through all that hell to get where I'm at.
A long time.
A long time. I mean, I was done wrong on top of wrong. And I stuck it out. Most God bless me. Keep on.
Then a scion came out against us.
Mm-hmm.
He and all his people to fight at Jabez.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord our God delivered him before us.
Uh-huh.
And we smote him and his son and all the people.
Uh-huh.
After we gave them our cloak and our shoes and our swords and our staves and all that stuff. And the Lord, wait a minute. And we took all his cities at that time.
I told you the Most High, I told you. They read the book.
They know.
When they see your face and you got any color in your skin at all.
What did God tell them to come in here and take from me?
They call you a thief. I'm telling you, it's right in the pages. Our ancestors took every damn thing that they had.
That's right.
Everywhere they went, they took it. You know why? Because the Most High told them to take it.
Yep.
They was up under the guidance of the Most High. Take it. Mm-hmm. Shit, let's move on.
And utterly destroyed the men and the women.
See that?
And the little ones.
Kill them all.
Of every city.
See that? He does not care.
Make you feel good.
He does not care.
You got something to look forward to, Israel.
See, they got some shit coming, boy. A lot of them just don't know.
A lot of them know.
But you got to pay for this shit.
They trying to get rid of these men.
You got to pay for this, boy.
We left none to remain.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Okay, now that was 30,
That was 35.
Okay, 35. All right. Now, let's go to Proverbs chapter 20. Now, watch it, my brothers and sisters. Proverbs chapter 20. We're going to read verses 19 down to 30, down to 25. Proverbs chapter 20.
And see, a lot of this we're going to explain to y'all later on because it ain't us fighting for the enemy to leave us alone.
Sure ain't.
It's always somebody else.
It's always somebody else.
They always fighting for alcohol, they say.
But they're fighting for their own selves.
This is something for they. This
they're
is
not fighting for us.
They ain't fighting for us. Ain't no Hebrew Israelite standing up saying a damn thing about cattle stopping what they do.
Sure ain't.
God don't move Israel that way.
It's the mother ones.
It's the mother folk.
No, let's keep going. All right.
You want Proverbs 20? Where we start?
Let's start with verse 19.
Verse 19. Let me get down here. He that goeth about as a table bearer.
Table bearer.
Receiveth secrets.
Uh-huh.
Meaning, the one that's pouring the drinks.
Mm-hmm.
And bringing out the food. Y'all seen it before. When the person, you seen it in these little shows that they show y'all about how the servants are in there with, they sitting serving out the master. Therefore, meddleth not with him that flattereth with his lips.
And see, like we say here a lot of times, you find them, they're running here and they're running there, coming, running their mouth, and doing all kind of old shit. It's the number of tail bearer. Don't mess with them. Leave them alone.
Mm-hmm. Somebody always want to tell you, girl, let me tell you, so-and-so did. Whoso curses his father or his mother.
And not like, you know, MF or damn or fuck you.
Wish they daddy did.
They ain't talking about that.
Well, let's say like let's use the Medindaz brothers.
Yeah.
That's a curse. They cursed their parents.
And they did.
They wished them dead and they did it.
And they did it. That's right. Let's keep
his lamp shall be put out in obscure darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And inheritance may be gotten hastily at the beginning, but the end thereof shall not be a blessing. I mean, few $14 million for what? A few days. They was on their tail.
All right.
Say not thou, I will recompense evil. But wait on the Lord.
Now see, he's talking about who? Family members.
That's right.
They're only dealing with family members. They're not dealing with somebody outside the family.
That's right. Just family.
Just family.
Wait on the Lord.
Wait on the Lord. The Lord gonna deal with him. The Most High is gonna deal with it. Let's keep on.
And he shall save thee.
See that?
Divers weights are an abomination unto the Lord. And a false balance is not good.
See that? See that?
Man, this thing weigh 5
false balance.
No, I don't. You steady said, no, I don't.
You got the scale fucked up. Because it's showing you a false reading. Keep on.
Men's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own way?
Oh, but you got a lot of them out there. You got a lot of them out there. I know this and I know. No, you don't. No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Let's keep on.
All right. It is a snare to the man who devoureth that which is holy. And after vows to make iniquity.
See that? He's talking about the ones that are in the family. He's not talking about somebody outside the family. He's talking about the ones in the family. Let's keep on.
A wise king scattereth the wicked. And bringeth the will over them. The spirit of man is the candle of the Lord. Searching all the inward parts of the battle.
All right.
Mercy and truth preserved king. And his throne is upholden by mercy.
Okay.
The glory of young men is their strength. And the beauty of old men is the gray.
All right. Now y'all can go ahead and finish reading the rest of this right here. But now let's jump on down to, let's go to Job. Job 31. Now watch my brother and sister. You can go to Job 31. See, because I want you guys to listen to this right now closely. I want you guys to listen to it because there's a lot of golden nuggets in here. And I want you guys to get them all. See, because a lot of time we be worried about this one and worried about that. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about nothing. Don't worry about it. Israel.
Don't worry we about just it. Taught that to you. Don't worry.
Now let's look at Job chapter 31. Let's read. Let's start with verse 24.
All right.
Now watch it, my brothers and sisters. Listen closely.
All right, 24. If I had made gold my hope, or have said to the fine gold, thou art my confidence. If I rejoice because my wealth was great, and because mine hand hath gotten much, if I behold the sun when it shineth, or the moon walking in brightness.
All right.
And my heart hath been secretly enticed. Or my mouth hath kissed my hand. This also were an iniquity to be punished by the judge. For I should have denied the God that is above. If I rejoice at the destruction of him that hateth me.
Now he's talking about
your brother.
That's in the family. Keep on.
Or lifted up myself when evil found him. Neither have I suffered my mouth to sin by wishing a curse to his soul.
Talking about his brother.
So he was wishing to say curse words.
See that? No, he just described
to you what you wished for. That's a curse.
That's a curse. Now let's keep on. 31.
If the men of my tabernacle.
Stop right there. That tells you that he's talking about the family. He's not talking about outside people. He's talking about those that are in the family. Keep on.
Said not. Oh, that we had of his flesh.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot be satisfied.
All right. Now, let's go to Job chapter 14. It's there in the book. Now, y'all listen to this very closely now, because Job has a whole lot in his writings. And you can learn a whole lot in this book here. I mean, it tells you about all sorts of stuff. Now, let's start with verse 1, and we're going to read down to verse 17, okay?
Man that is born of a woman.
All right, y'all listen now. Y'all listen.
Is of a few days and full of trouble.
Trouble going to come.
Just like a Jesus.
Trouble is going to come. Can't get around it. Let's keep on.
He cometh forth like a flower.
Uh-huh. Talking about man.
And is cut down.
Uh-huh.
He fleeth also as a shadow.
Uh-huh.
And continueth not.
See that? Here today and gone tomorrow. Keep on.
And doest thou open thine eyes upon such a one, and bringeth me unto judgment with thee?
Mm-hmm.
Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one.
That's right. See that? Not one.
May Ray.
Huh. Okay.
Seeing his days are determined.
I told y'all guys, y'all days are determined. Just because one go out here and he dies, he get killed or whatever, when breath leave his body, that was his appointed time. It's time for his ass to die.
And see what messes y'all up is.
I don't care what
you read things like the king turned his face to the wall and prayed and got 15 more years. Mm. Y'all read that and you say, oh, well, I can do that too.
No, you can't.
Oh, I'll just do that.
No, you can't.
I'll pray and have God prolong my life.
That's only one time.
Our days are numbered. All right.
Let's keep on.
That it says, thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass.
Listen what he says here. It says, hold. You missed part of it. It said, the number of his months.
Oh, yeah. Are with thee.
Uh-huh.
Thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass.
You're not going to live 1 second past the time that he said you're going to die. I don't care whether you drunk your damn self to death. I don't care whether you smoke yourself to death. I don't care whether
live healthy
and then you just drop dead running around the fucking track course or whatever. Once you come to your end of your damn line, that's it.
Oh, he was too young to die. Well, not according to God.
It was time for him to go.
The moments, the months, the
it
day,
was
time
was for you
time.
To go. So stop worrying about dying. Whenever it's time for you to die, you're going to die.
That's right.
Ain't nothing you can do about it. Nothing you can do. You just don't die on accident. It was already planned
just
for your ass to die.
Just wishing to die. They pray every day that they die, yeah. And they keep writing.
Right in the pages. I ain't making this up. Come on.
Turn from him that he may rest.
Uh-huh.
Till he shall accomplish. As an hireling this
his day. Mm-hmm.
For there is hope of a tree.
Listen now.
If it be cut down,
uh-huh.
That it would sprout again.
Uh-huh. Listen now.
And that the tender branch thereof will not cease.
Okay, keep on.
Though the root thereof wax old in the earth,
uh-huh.
And the stalk thereof die in the ground,
uh-huh.
Yet though the scent of
water,
it will bud,
uh-huh.
And bring forth
bulbs
like a plant.
Mm-hmm.
But man dies,
uh-huh.
And wither away.
Wasteth away. Mm-hmm.
Yea, man giveth up the ghost.
Uh-huh.
And
Where is he? Keep on.
As the waters fell from the sea,
mm-hmm.
And the flood decayeth, the drieth up.
Mm-hmm.
So man lieth down and riseth not.
Mm-hmm.
Till the heavens be no more,
uh-huh.
They shall not awake, nor be risen out of their sleep.
See that? Now
he's talking
about our ancestors. They're asleep. Now let's keep on.
So how did Jesus do all what he said? Oh, that thou wouldest hide me in the grave.
See, that Job was telling the Most High, listen.
That thou wouldest keep me secret.
Hide me in the grave, huh?
Until thy wrath be past.
Uh-huh.
That thou wouldest appoint me a set time.
See that? See that?
And remember me. Then get me up, Father.
See that? See that?
Wait till you do all that bad stuff. I don't want to be there for that.
There is an appointed time that God is going to raise all of our ancestors up. Y'all don't need Jesus. Jesus ain't no motherfucking resurrection.
You don't need his salvation.
Jesus ain't shit.
Show love.
It's right in the pages. I ain't making this up. He said that would appoint me a set time and remember me.
Let me sleep in the ground, Father.
Hide me in the ground.
Hide me.
Now let's keep on.
If a man die, shall he live again?
Huh? Question.
All the days of my appointed time will I wait.
Job said, I'm waiting on who? The Most High. Keep on.
Till my change.
It's coming. He's going to bring me back.
Come on now.
He's going to bring me back. I don't need Jesus. My change is going to come.
That's right.
I'm getting up out of this grave. Let's keep on.
Thou shalt call.
Uh-huh.
And baby, I will
answer. Oh, look at that. The Most High will say, get up, Job. Job said, I'm coming, Dad. It's right in the pages. I ain't making this up. Keep on.
Thou shalt have a desire to the work of thine hand.
Uh-huh. See that? The Most High made me. Huh? With his hands. Mm-hmm. He made me. Keep on.
For now thou numberest my steps.
See that?
Doest thou not watch over my sin?
Know everything you're doing. See, that's why I tell you, ain't no secrets. Wherever you go, the Most High is always there. He knows what's going on. See what I'm saying? So when your ass is all jacked up in trouble, oh Lord, I know where you are. I put you there. Right in the pages.
Mm.
I ain't making this up. Keep on.
My transgression is sealed up in the
bag. Look what he says. All the bad things I've done, the Most High got in the bag and seal it up. But keep on.
And thou sewest up my iniquity.
Sold the bag up. Sold it up. Done with it.
I'm getting into it.
Done with it.
Done. I ain't got to worry about no more. I'm done with that.
Now let's go to Job chapter 1. We're going to read this right now in Job chapter 1, and then we're gonna close out with that, because we got to talk about some other stuff. Job chapter 1, let's read verses 21, 22, and 23.
All right.
See, because we need to, the Christian need to understand this. Y'all just seen what Job said about the Most High.
You mean 21 and 22?
Yeah, let's read that one.
All right. Unless I don't have the right, mine only goes to 22, you said in 23.
No, 22, 21,
mm-hmm.
and 22. Mm-hmm.
And said,
mm-hmm. Now, this is Job.
Naked I came out of my mother's womb.
Mm-hmm.
And naked shall I return thither.
See that? Y'all see that? Mm-hmm. Keep on.
The Lord gave and the Lord taketh away.
Not no devil. Y'all Christian, y'all got it all fucked up. Y'all got it twisted. Y'all got it wrong.
Hmm.
Satan ain't never killed nobody. You can't show me a scripture nowhere in the Bible where Satan killed anybody at any time.
Not one verse.
The Most High said, I kill. Job is telling you right here. All across the spectrum, it is the Most High that giveth. And it is the Most High that taketh away. Keep on going.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
See that? See that? See, Job know that he doesn't need Jesus to get him up. Job know that. Why can't y'all Christians see it?
Know it.
Job knows that he doesn't need Jesus to get him up. He said the Most High gonna get him up.
And when he get up, he gonna be brand new, cause he ain't gonna have to worry about no sin, iniquity, and
nothing. Everything that he did, the Most High got in the bag, and not only the bag is sealed, and he sold it. Can't get up. I mean, We got it so easy, my brothers and sisters.
We really do.
We have it so easy. I'm talking to Israel. I ain't talking to everybody else. I'm talking to Israel. Baby, you got it so easy. It's right here in the pages.
If you could just get that little bit of Egyptian you got in you out, you'd be all right with God.
I remember our science teacher in the school that we went to, he used to be telling us about, you know, read and look in the book, and we be clowning and stuff. He said, baby, look in the book. It ain't going to bite you. Oh, boy.
It's not done away with, Christians. It's here. It's still here.
My brother and sister.
Alive and doing well.
My brother and sister, but you guys have to see this thing. I mean, it's right here. Nobody needs Jesus for a damn thing.
Not for a damn thing.
Nothing. And Jesus is not God.
Nor his son.
He's not. Neither his son.
Nor his neighbor.
No affiliation at all.
No.
I said over and over, and a lot of my brothers and sisters out there say the same thing. Jesus ain't shit. Damn Jesus.
Damn Jesus.
That's what they say. And we all say it. Damn Jesus. Ain't shit.
Jesus ain't shit.
Now my brother
said, all this Job sinned not,
mm-hmm.
nor charged God falsely.
Mm-hmm.
And see, Israel, I'm going to tell y'all. Like I said, you know, we wished that we could petition the Most High again. Which we're not going to get on his nerves, believe me. Because we done been to him 2 or 3 times about it. But we wish we could hear from you on YouTube, too. Because mm-hmm. I know you would like to bless the Most High God in writing. But on Facebook, Israel has grown so much. Oh, my goodness.
And we can see the work of the Most High.
The things that they used to say compared mm-hmm. to the things they say now. It's all about their God.
We can see the Most High working, goodness. Boy. We can see the Most High working.
Yes, indeed.
And my brothers and sisters, the Most High is calling all of your brothers and sisters home. It's little bit by little bit. But they're coming. Just stay patient.
They're coming. Y'all be patient.
Stay patient.
Wait on the Most High.
Wait. Keep on reading. Keep on studying. Keep on learning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you're going to look around one day and you're going to see all your sisters and brothers.
Mm-hmm.
Right here at lightofminimal.org. I'm telling you the truth.
You're going to see them here.
Now, we're going to get on some current events right here. We're going to show you guys something now. I want you to show them this video here.
But what we're dealing with tonight is, y'all notice we have on jerseys, and we tried to find somebody who we knew was not married to cattle.
Right.
I don't think he's married yet, and if he marries cattle, we're going to burn these. We had to burn our Redskins jerseys.
Yeah, RG3, whatever the name is.
We was going to try to ride with him back when he first started.
Yeah.
Spend all that money on them jerseys, and then we had to burn them.
Throw them trash pile and set it
to
place.
Hopefully we can hold on to these because mm-hmm. we know he's not married to cattle. But we're dealing with this, what is he? Supposed to be a president?
He ain't shit.
With the orange one, the almighty clown of America, which is true. You know, I think George Washington was a clown because when everything goes back, you know, he has to put somebody in. It was like the
mm-hmm.
other one.
Yep.
So he says a bunch of foolish things, mm-hmm. and it's got people worked up everywhere. So mm-hmm. we're going to play that, and then we're going to give you Israel's take on what's going on, okay? Mm-hmm. So let me see if I can get this going for you right quick. Let's see if I can see if y'all can see that. I hope you can. See upside down
there, yeah.
NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag,
our flag.
Our flag.
That son of a bitch off the field.
Not their flag. Our flag.
Fire! Disrespects our flag.
Our flag.
Is fired. And that owner, they don't know it. They don't know. They're friends of mine, many of them. They don't know. They'll be the most popular person for a week. They'll be the most popular person in this country. Because that's a total disrespect of our heritage.
Our heritage.
Total disrespect of everything that we stand
for. We stand for.
Everything that we stand for.
Not what they, not their heritage or what they stand for, but our heritage and what we stand for.
Different freedoms, but you know what? It's still totally disrespectful. And you know, when the NFL ratings are down massively, the NFL ratings are down massively. Now, the number one reason happens to be that they like watching what's happening on, you know, with your screen.
Yeah, this is a presidential speech, and he's talking about the NFL.
You know, today, if you hit too hard, right, they hit too hard, 15 yards, throw him out of the game. They had that last week. I watched for a couple of minutes. Two guys just really beautiful tackle. Boom, 15 yards. The referee gets on television. His wife is sitting at home. She's so proud of him. They're ruining the game. Right? They're ruining the game. Hey, look, that's what they want to do. They want to hit. Okay? They want to hit. But it is hurting the game. But you know what's hurting the game more than that? When people...
It's hurting the game. Why isn't it hurting our game?
Playing our great national anthem.
Our... Not their great national anthem.
The only thing you can do better is if you see it, even if it's one player, leave the stadium. I guarantee things will stop. Things will stop. Just pick up and leave. Pick up and leave. Not the same game anymore, anyway.
Nah, all right, y'all.
Now, y'all see how that... y'all see how he rolls? We keep on saying it over and over. Talking to Israel. This is not your lane. And they let you know it all the time. Mm-hmm. It's always I, we. Mm-hmm. They are excluding you.
He never once said they are disrespecting their flag.
Mm-hmm. Or their national anthem is ours.
Their national anthem, their country. It's always our. But we're basically here tonight to tell y'all that Israel is not taking any parts in all that.
Please.
You know
don't.
Why? Because God does all these things for a reason. Mm-hmm. We told y'all, little by little.
That's right.
God is going to take everything away from them.
That's right.
And see, there is no football without black players.
That's right.
And everybody's talking about, all the coaches are standing for the... Listen, mm-hmm. this Kaepernick fella doesn't know anything about our plight.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't know anything about our hardship and what we've had to deal with. He's heard about it, but he doesn't know anything about it. It's always someone else standing up for us. God didn't ask anybody to stand up for
That's
us
right.
or what we went through.
He said, no man shall save you.
No, no man.
No
now,
man.
When he did that the first time, where was all these black coons when he first went down on the knee for
mm-hmm.
black folks, so-called?
Mm-hmm.
They didn't all bow then.
Sure didn't.
Huh? But when Trump called they mama bitches,
because
mm-hmm. he certainly called them bitches.
Sure did.
Then they all lock arms.
Mm-hmm.
And they didn't come out to because of the black folks. It's that what they did had nothing to do with what the black folks have gone through.
Kept
you know how I know?
No.
The reason why we know is because 95% of them are married to cattle.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
They don't care anything about black people.
They sure don't.
They didn't even want to reproduce black mm-hmm. people.
They sure don't.
I don't give a damn if they laid their bodies on the field.
Mm-hmm.
Those men don't mean anything to us here at Lie to Me No
they
More.
They sure don't.
Because nothing. Those are rich men of color,
mm-hmm.
non-Hebrew Israelites, mm-hmm. and I will tell you to your face,
mm-hmm.
non-Hebrew Israelites, because you must be under the curse.
That's right.
They are not under the curse.
Mm-hmm. 'Cause they're prosperous.
They are wealthy men.
Mm-hmm.
All of them.
That's right.
That didn't give a damn about our plight
mm-hmm.
when they chose to marry white women.
Cattle.
And reproduce something
mm-hmm.
that we don't know what it is, 'cause mm-hmm. God doesn't call it by any name.
Sure don't.
Okay, we'll get into that another time.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, we're here to tell y'all tonight.
So you're going to show them the difference between that
I don't have time because we got to get it posted. We got a late start tonight, but we'll get it posted. Mm-hmm. We'll bring some of this up to you another time. But do we watch the games?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I like football.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy football.
Mm-hmm.
I'm watching the same coons I would be watching if they wasn't holding arms. I'm watching the same coons if they wasn't down on one knee. Mm-hmm. I'm watching the same coons that didn't get up and do it when Kaepernick first did it.
Mm-hmm.
I got to see somebody like Ray Lewis.
Yeah, and Kanye West.
He should have been dressed in whiteface.
Mm-hmm.
I don't give a damn about the owners or the players.
Sorry, bastard.
Get out there and play fucking football. Mm-hmm. That's all I'm concerned with. Their flag, I don't give a shit.
Mm-hmm.
Their country, I don't give a shit.
Mm-hmm.
Their national anthem, I don't give a shit.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Now he's turned it to be about the veterans.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody ever said they were against the fucking vets. Well, you want to know who's against the fucking vets?
Mm-hmm.
President Trump, the senators, the governors, and the mayors, and the people who let them lay on the streets at night.
Mm-hmm.
Who let them deal with their sickness and disease that they don't get them help for.
Mm-hmm. You know, he's the main one that's against the vets. You remember how he talked about John McCain,
sure did.
How many planes he crashed
and how he got caught. I don't like those that get caught. So mm-hmm. we know the ones that are struggling, he don't like y'all.
Sure
y'all does. Not his kind of a mm-hmm. vet.
That's right. But he's such a liar anyway.
Do we care if football leaves? Hell no.
Nope.
Do we care if they start doing it in basketball and basketball leaves?
Nope.
Hell no. What the fuck do I care that they don't get no money?
I don't care.
It ain't never benefited me.
Sure ain't.
So we just wanted to stress the fact that they can get down on one knee, one ass, one head,
yep.
whatever they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
It don't change nothing with Israel.
Sure don't.
No man can save
no
you.
No man.
You are waiting for Elijah to
That's
come.
Right.
I post that shit because it's funny. I post that shit to show how these so-called blacks act and what the things that
mm-hmm.
they do. I don't give a damn about none of them. Coaches, none of them.
None of that bullshit.
They're not my people.
All we care about is our people.
I only care about my people. And it's
That's
always
it.
Using my plight
mm-hmm.
for somebody's soapbox.
And LiedToMeNoMore.org is all about.
And you get nothing out of it. White police have been killing black men for the past 2 years at astronomical numbers.
That's right.
And ain't nobody burned their tickets or jerseys or stopped going to the game
sure
or
ain't.
Nothing else.
Mm-mm. Sure ain't.
So no, Israel, don't pay that shit no attention. Don't fall for the okey-doke.
That's right. Let them do their own thing.
Let them do their thing. They don't care nothing about your situation.
Sure
never have and never will.
And we gonna wait on Elijah.
We're waiting on Elijah to return.
That's our goal. So my brothers and sisters, we hope that this has been a very, very informative teaching. And we thank you guys for allowing us to come into your homes. And we praise the Most High for you guys.
Give him all the praise.
And we love you guys.
Love you.
And we're always thinking about you guys.
We thank you for your blessed comments because I finally got the date night video to work.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you for your comments. Just beautiful people. Just beautiful.
And we thank you guys for everything. And that's from the bottom of our hearts. And we got all your requests.
We got
all
yeah,
guys,
I'm caught up.
You know, the Most High heard our voices, and he's going to take care of his business.
Yes, he is. Everybody's prayers have been taken before the Most High
That's right.
God. He
mm-hmm.
has your request.
That's right. So, my brothers and sisters, again, we thank you guys, and we love you guys.
We love you.
And until our Sabbath,
shalom.